guys, being that we are a Star Wars YouTube channel, a lot of people want to know my thoughts about not just the Mandalorian season finale, but the Mandalorian season as a whole. So let's talk about this, okay? So, if you guys watched my video about the Mandalorian season finale, I have some opinions. I was disappointed. I wanted Boba so much. All the signs pointed to Boba showing up. But that's not why I was disappointed in the finale. That was something that was disappointing, yes, but there's little decisions in this finale that just didn't seem right to me. Like, one of the decisions that felt very weird was there was no real explanation just how Gideon was able to break the Darksaber. And some people are kind of trying to solve it online, like, well, he made Dark Trooper armor mixed with Mando armor and Beskar versus Beskar, so he should have been able to break it. So they indicate the lightsaber is Beskar, but I don't know. I'm still going to have issues with the Darksaber being gone, being that it was such an iconic weapon, and that was... And it felt very anticlimactic. Another thing is, if Gideon's really dead, that was such a... There was no real, like, conclusion to his passing. It was very weird. Like, so now a lot of people have theories that the clones are the ones, because he didn't have the mustache. A lot of people think that one of the clones, but he didn't... But the clones didn't have the mustache either, so it's like, have you been seeing a different Gideon the entire time? We'll have to wait and see. But now we're going to judge the whole season, okay? This season of The Mandalorian was, and I never thought I would say these words for a Star Wars property since the sequel trilogy, this season was lackluster. I know people might disagree, but I was severely disappointed in this season of The Mandalorian. It's solely focused on Bo-Katan, which, if you love the character, that's great. But I watched The Mandalorian to watch Pedro Pascal and Grogu have their adventures. So seeing them take a backseat made me not love the story as much. The writing was a bit sloppy. We started out really strong with the first two episodes, and then we kind of went, oh, side quest, oh, side quest, oh, gotta go be with the Mandalorian group, side quest. Too many side quests. And episode 6 really just being so weird and mediocre was just really sad. This, I know there's good writing in this, I know they have good people, but unfortunately because of clashes with Kathleen Kennedy and other problems, we just didn't get as good of a season as I wanted. And so it was disappointing to see that this season was not as good as the previous two seasons. I think Mandalorian Season 2 is 100 times better than this. I think Mandalorian Season 1 is 100 times better than this, which we'll get into in my next video as well. But overall, guys, Season 3 was mixed for me. I liked the first two episodes. I liked aspects of the finale, but I have problems. I liked the episode with the pirates. I thought that was good. But overall, the Mandalorian season was a bit of a letdown for me. I really hope Season 4 can make it up, though, because I think Season 4 has potential to be very good. I love we're going back to Mando being a bounty hunter. I love that we're going to work with the New Republic. I think there is potential to get a better season. And I hope we do. So anyway, guys, if you guys liked this video about my thoughts on Mando Season 3, let me know yours in the comments below, and I'll see you in the next video.